guys, good afternoon. It's the Sunday after Thanksgiving, and I hope you guys had a nice holiday if you celebrate it in your family. Today I'm going to be coloring with POSCA markers on a mini canvas by Blick, and I'm coloring a little fan art of Amaterasu from Okami. It's a present for somebody. And I'm going to go over my process. So the first thing I did was I sketched out my design, and I did it in pencil, and you can even still see faint pencil marks on it. And then I inked it with a Mitsuo Aida Brushpen, which is waterproof and Copic proof. It's kind of my go-to brushpen for those kind of for that kind of a usage, because it's the only one I've found that can handle both water and Copics. And once that had dried for 24 hours, I erased it with a mono eraser. And today I'm going to be painting it with water-based POSCA markers. They're permanent when they're dry. And I'm going to be using these cheap nylon brushes. They're Dollar Roundy brushes from Walmart to help me with the blending. So let's get started. I think I'm gonna start with the grass. No, maybe I should do the sky first, because the sky is gonna be the hardest thing to do. Yeah, I'm gonna start with the sky. And you can get POSCA markers on Amazon. I think you can get them through Dick Blick. You can get them through Jet Pins. I'm using the finest tip that aren't the fine liner pins, because I tend to work small. And I like using POSCA on canvas rather than paper, because I find that the nibs on POSCA markers tend to tear up the paper. So I'm going to fill in the whole sky with this light blue, and oh, that's no good. That's fine. We can. So if you get POSCA while it's if you hit your mistakes while they're still wet, you can pick them up. So that was good that I messed up a little bit, because I could demonstrate that really quick. It's one of the pluses of POSCA markers. They are permanent, however, when they're fully dry. So you want to get that when it's still wet. And you don't want your brush to be sopping wet either. You want it to just be damp. That's why I have the paper towel underneath my nylon brushes. And that's also why I'm using synthetic brushes rather than natural fiber brushes. So now we have the whole sky colored in, and I'm going to take a moment just to let the POSCA dry. And after the POSCA is dry, I'm going to use dark blue and light blue to add a little gradation to the sky. OK, Okay, so my light blue has finally dried, and it's time to do shading on the sky with the dark blue and the white. So we're going to use the dark blue at the top of the sky, because the sky is like a bowl, and it gets darker the further up you get. And you might have to go back and forth with this, because the dark blue is very dark, and you're going to have to blend out with your wet brush a lot. And I like using flats for this just because they stand up a little bit better to the POSCA. So as you can see, we're already getting a blend in the dark blue and the lighter blue. And you can even, as long as you have paint on your paintbrush, you can even extend it out and continue to blend it, which is pretty neat. POSCAs in general are pretty neat. They're very different from any other. I'm not an acrylic painter. I did some in my undergrad, but I don't really care for them. However, acrylics or other opaque paint markers, they open the medium up a little bit more to me. So if you are like me and you've always had a harder time with acrylics for whatever reason, you may find paint markers like POSCA, which I don't think are acrylic, but I'm not really sure what they're made of, or Liquitex acrylic or Montana acrylic markers. You may find them easier to use than traditional acrylics. And another plus to working on canvas, gessoed canvas, over working on paper is that your acrylic can stay, your POSCA or your acrylic will stay wet a little bit longer. So you see, we've already got a little bit of gradation to the sky, and it's a little difficult to do because I'm working around the tree. And it's okay if you get it into the, because POSCA is opaque, unless you add water, it's okay if you kind of get it into the branches or get it somewhere where the paint doesn't really belong, because you're going to be covering that up later with another color. Sorry. All right, so that's the first potential layer for blue. I'm going to see how it dries, and I may rework it. It's a lot less smooth on the physical product than it is on the video. But I can actually start working in the white, because the bottom of the sky would be where the sky is the lightest. And I'm dabbing out most of the water from my brush onto a paper towel that's a little bit on camera, but mostly not. So as you can see, it's very easy to blend POSCA in this way. And I know people who also blend POSCA by working wet marker into wet marker. And I don't necessarily care for that way, but you may find it works for you, especially if you're working on bigger areas than this. This is a small canvas. And if I decide the white isn't, the sky isn't light enough at the bottom, I'll probably go in and do another layer. I tend to work in multiple layers until I reach a saturation I like. And I personally like to let my layers dry, let the water evaporate. I can't talk tonight. I'm sorry. I've got a little bit of a headache. I try to let the layers dry before I add additional layers. So the bottom of my sky is wet and the top of my sky is wet. And I'm trying to decide if I'm going to go back into the sky. I might. We'll see. I'll let it dry and I'll get back to you. All right, the dark blue is dry enough that I can go in. And I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to add hints of darker blue around the corners of things, kind of like an implied shadow to kind of hopefully help push depth a little bit. The grass and the cherry blossoms next. Alright, so that's dry. I think I'm going to do the grass first, and I'm going to use this green and this yellow. And I'm trying to use flicking grass-like strokes, and I don't want to leave too much canvas white. And if there is white, I will probably try to cover that up later with the yellow, because I'm going for like kind of a fresh spring green. And the light green that comes with the POSCA markers is really... It's like a seafoam, so it's not really useful in this case. Put in my first layer of green, and I've already pulled out the other colors I want in the grass, so I'm going to go ahead and do the pink cherry blossoms, or at least some of them. And if you have trouble getting your POSCA markers to cover an area opaquely enough, it's okay to allow them to dry fully and then put another layer on. I've also, I think I have mentioned this before, the whole artist's slash creators offering online classes on things like creativity or inspiration, but or finding your own style, but they don't necessarily have much background and they haven't necessarily done much research on the topic. I'm not white, I'm sorry, yellow. With my yellow POSCA. And I think the basic set of POSCAs is the 15. I know there are some other colors available. They are currently on my wish list, so I'd love to get a hold of them, but I'm currently working with the 15. Sorry. If your marker starts drying out, my blue gets a lot of use for some reason. You can pump it a couple of times and that helps get the paint going. And I'll let that dry, and I think I might go back in with it with the green to make the blue a little more subtle. And I'm still waiting on some areas of my pink to dry. And it's a very brash pink. It's like a bubblegum pink, which is way brighter than real cherry blossoms. But that's why I'm going to use white and purple to kind of help even them out. And I'm trying to decide if I want to do a very watered down red for Amaterasu's shading, or if I want to do like the sky blue but very watered down. And there's also a gray. I guess I could do the gray. And then I was gonna go over her markings with the red POSCA. Maybe I could even do like the interior of her ears with a red. Would probably be pretty cute. Oh yeah, I said I was gonna do green. To just kinda make it a little more subtle. Cause it's really garish to me right now. And POSCA markers do have a little bit of a learning curve, but I think they're a lot of fun to use, and they're very affordable markers, very versatile markers. So, and they don't handle anything like alcohol-based markers. So if you're like, is this a replacement for alcohol-based markers? No, not at all. Those are translucent. These are opaque. They are both permanent. These can be blended with water. Alcohol-based markers can be blended with very high-proof rubbing alcohol, but preferably blender solution, blender marker. These do not come with a POSCA markers do not come with a blender marker. They can be layered, however. I mean, so can alcohol markers. They're just different. It's like watercolor and acrylic, different. Different from each other. So I am shading the pink cherry blossoms with some purple. And the nice thing, as you guys have figured out, is they can be layered, so I can go back in if it's too purple and add more pink. I can add white highlights. It doesn't have to be this dark. You just need to be a little patient, which is something I sometimes have trouble with. My grass is pretty dry, so I can put my hand there, help rest it, because there's like almost an inch difference between the canvas and my desktop, so it helps to be able to rest my hand very lightly on the canvas. So what are your favorite markers, paint pens to work with? What do you guys use? What are your favorite techniques? What do you like to paint on? I've seen some really cool surfboard art done with POSCAs. I've seen people drawing hats and shoes, like Vans, with POSCAs, and that looks really cool. I've seen I guess those are my favorite. I mean, I've seen people work with it on paper and do like it just incredible imagery. They're so much more advanced with this than I am. This is like kind of that material I noodle around with in between doing watercolors. It's like for fun for me. It's not serious. I don't expect it to be a moneymaker. I'm not going to offer POSCA commissions at conventions because it would be different, but it's not necessarily a medium I currently am all that interested in perfecting. It's just for fun. Which is kind of rare for me, so I'd like to keep it that way. You might see this giant honking bandage on my hand. I sliced my hand really good cutting onions the other day. And by really good, I mean really bad. I almost passed out from, like, the blood. It's been kind of hindering everything I do. I don't think about how much I use my left hand until it's out of commission, and then I'm just like, oh, no. But it doesn't stop me from inking or painting, so that's nice. It would have been the worst if it was my right hand. I really would have been in trouble. I would have been so sad. Okay, so that's my shadow from my cherry blossoms. I'm gonna add pink again, and then I'm gonna add white. And I guess it's time to really start thinking seriously about Amaterasu, because she's kind of a holdup now. And you could probably super delicately apply colors if you had like a piece of white scrap plastic, just something non-porous. I don't have any handy. You guys have seen me use masking tape as like a little side palette kind of thing. I think that is way too, it's gonna absorb the POSCA and the water. So I want to avoid that. And I really just want to give the insides of her ears like a pinky kind of color, like dog ears. But I think the pink is too hot, too much pink. And I think I might go with the gray for her fur and maybe live to regret it. We'll see. That's like the best part of art is making mistakes and exploring. One of the best parts about art, making things, exploring. One of the other nice things is when you do have the opportunity to connect to other people, when other people talk to you or get excited about things you've worked on, that is a great thing. It's been kind of rare for me these days, but hopefully I'll see more of that. So if this gets too gray, and we're not going to really know until, you know, a little further on, you can always add the white on top and blend it out, just like we've been blending with pretty much everything else. So fear not. Do not worry. I think I'm actually going to go back and add pink. Oh, okay. Since I grabbed purple, I think I will fix that one stray blossom clump. So it has some shade. It's not just flat. And then I'm going to go and add pink back in. And there's some areas where I want it to be more pinky purple. So I'm going to add water to those areas. Kind of blend them out. Maybe blend some of these out a little bit too. And I'm going to have to go back in with the purple right underneath and draw the shadow. But I just wanted to like kind of lighten up how purple it was getting. Because it was looking less like cherry blossoms and more like fuchsia. It actually looks kind of muddy right there. So when it dries, I'm gonna do something about it, fix it in some capacity. It's another exciting thing for me about POSCA is I don't always know how I'm going to, with watercolor, unless things just like really get out of hand. I've been doing it long enough that I kind of know how to solve a lot of the problems that I encounter. And sometimes I know also that like I can keep trying, but it's gonna get worse, because that's how watercolor is. Can get muddy. Pigments can get transferred, and it can be a mess. But with POSCA, I don't always know how I'm going to solve a problem, and that's kind of exciting for me. All right, So the gray on her tail is dry. And I think I will end up doing white on her because that gray is a little more, she's looking more like she went rolling in charcoal than Amaterasu. You guys can't see. I'm sorry about that. As I say that, I'm like blending gray into the tail to add more depth. It'll work out. With POSCA, you just keep noodling around with it until it looks the way you need it to look. And I have a little dish of water to the side that I'm regularly dipping my brush in. I don't know how well y'all can see that. The teacher who taught me acrylic, or the teacher who taught acrylic in my undergrad, would talk about pushing and pulling the paint, and my favorite anatomy teacher when I was at SCAD talked about pushing and pulling and massaging the piece until it's where you want it to be. So, it's like that. You're just working things until they look correct. And I think I can go in with white now. On the cherry tree. And you might even want to do another layer, or I might even do another layer of white after this, just to make it more opaque. And I think I might even blend some of it out if I can, just to get like even more layers, more texture, more visual interest. Oh, too much water. I thought I'd dab that off, but I didn't. And what's also neat about using a brush to help blend is sometimes you can get like a more brushy look, more painterly quality. So depending on what you want out of your markers, that might be perfect for you. I'm always down for like a painterly look in my markers. We're almost always down. I'm probably going to go back in and even add more pink and purple. Because with POSCA, you can do that. You can go back and forth as much as you need to. So that your what you're doing looks the way you need it to. Or want it to. You also want to clean your marker out sometimes. And you can do that by pumping it on a sheet of paper or a paper towel, like Viva paper towels that have no loose fibers that could get caught in the nib. Probably a paper towel is the smartest way to do it. I mean, probably paper is the smartest way to do it, not necessarily that paper towel. And when I have her color the way I want it, I am going to probably draw a few stray flecks of grass over her feet, just to like help make it look like she's sitting in the grass, not sitting on the grass. Gotta quit moving it out of where you guys can see it. That's not fair. So I need to let this dry before I can continue. I'll be back in a bit. Alright, that's a little more dry. I'm gonna go back into the cherry blossoms and kind of break up that white. Make it look a little more like flowers and not like weird cloud lumps. I don't know about you guys, but days I have headaches, I end up so wiped, so tired. My allergies are really, really bad. Nashville thinks fall is rain, rain, rain until it gets cold, which is incredibly depressing. Whereas Louisiana, which I was visiting, thinks fall is spring. Spring until it's cold. So it's hard to get used to what I grew up with versus my new home. I know some areas get like lovely seasonal color. I would love to be there. I know Nashville does, but, like, I don't even leave. It's so rainy and gray. I don't even leave the house until like, it's quit raining every day. We have had some really beautiful days, though. I actually really, really like Nashville. I really like New Orleans, too. Every time I go, I get, like, incredibly homesick. I want to stay. Always end up talking about how much I love it. And see, I never ever would have realized how much I liked Louisiana until I'd moved away. Because when I was growing up, I felt like living there was incredibly restrictive. And I felt like I was never going to go anywhere living there. Which is unfair and not true, but like my family didn't vacation when I was a kid. We didn't go anywhere. So like I didn't know how the rest of the country really lived. All I knew is what my friends told me. And what television told me. Neither one of those is an unbiased, reliable source. Okay. When the pink dries, I'm going to go in and just add a few flecks of purple. But I'm pretty happy with that. And I got to do the, I probably should have done it first. Bum dum dum. Sorry. I might actually do something kind of neat where I just do the highlights in brown. And then yeah, that's much better. And maybe like go back over the black just with the POSCA, just to kind of, the black of the tree, just to kind of tighten it up. Because it's gotten a little bit covered over. But yeah, having the mix of the brown and the black is probably a good choice. That's weird how that grass is just like, oh! Dude, I have an idea for the grass. That's gonna help a lot. I'm just gonna put some blue in and then blend it out. And then if I need to, I can cut back in with the green. Come on. For some reason, it doesn't want to go anywhere. I might need to replace my blue POSCA. My dark blue POSCA. Even so, doing that actually does help the look of the grass. Makes it less cartoony. I mean, I know it is in general very cartoony, but now I know the grass under Ami is wet, so let's see if I can blend it a little bit more. There we go. Some of it's blending. I don't know what's going on with this grass. And I'm going to put some green a little later. We had talked about doing purple. Just here and there, just to kind of like push the shading of the tree. It's a lot more cartoony than that, than the cat. I did a speed video. And it's a lot more cartoony than the other illustrations I have prepared for the POSCA test for my blog post. But it's a present. And when I thought about POSCA markers, I thought it was a good fit. I still think it's a good fit. And hopefully the person who's receiving it likes it. It can't be a surprise because he edits my videos. He's gonna know. It's okay, I have some other surprise presents. And I actually do not give him art all that often. Isn't that funny? Dating an artist, you would think one of the perks would be all this free art. And one of my best friends is dating an artist. He's a good friend. The dude she's dating is a good friend of mine too. And she always, like, she really wants him to draw her. And I understand why. And you would think he would, but I think he's afraid to. He's really good at drawing guys. I have no idea how good he is at drawing women because I've never seen him draw women. And I think he might be afraid of insulting her. I tried to explain to him, like, even if it doesn't look super good the first time, like, just do more of them for her. You can always do more of them for her. It's better to learn how to draw women drawing your girlfriend than some stranger is gonna be angry at you. And I draw Joseph sometimes. Usually just like sketching him when he's hanging out, sitting. Did you guys see me get POSCA white all over the place? Well, fortunately, glass tabletops clean off with oh no! That's not... It's gonna clean off with Windex, but still, I'm gonna have to do it. I'm gonna have to clean it. And it's affecting my work area because it's like right in the middle of where I'm videoing. Yeah, I'm awesome. Cramping up really bad. Almost done. Almost. Ooh. Blue, you're goofing too. Okay, so what I have left is the black, darkening the black on the tree, and her red facial markings. I'm gonna try to get the black on the tree done without making a huge mess. Oh yeah, I want to do the ink dipped tail. There, hey, the tree looks pretty dang good, doesn't it? Let's get the tail started. And then we want to blend it out with water. That way it looks like she dipped it in ink. Seriously, though, Amaterasu is a super duper cutie. If this was Danganronpa, Amaterasu would be the super duper high school cute dog. And I'm going to go over the red on Ami's markings again. And I think I might add some white highlights to her eyes. But otherwise, oh man, I don't know. Let's see. I have mixed feelings about this guy. Just in this area. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put some blue down. And blend it back up into the sky. And we'll see how that looks. If it doesn't look good, I might scream. Just kidding. I wouldn't scream on camera. That suck. That would suck for you guys. That's a little bit better. Yeah. Maybe a little bit over here. Yeah. Oh.